Every minute, a dump truck worth of plastic enters our oceans. That's a very concerning statistic, but when we hear statistics like this about water pollution, the tendency is for people to feel removed, like the problem is happening far away. The Mississippi River drains about 40% of the United States waters into the Gulf of Mexico. St. Louis is the connecting point of the Missouri River, a tributary to the Mississippi that, combined in length, ranks fourth when compared to other world rivers. So, no pressure, but St. Louis tends to stand out when considering the challenges and solutions of water pollution.
Today, we are launching the Mississippi River Plastic Pollution Initiative here in St. Louis.
Led by the Mississippi River Cities and Towns Initiative, St. Louis is one of three cities involved in the Plastic Pollution Initiative that, unlike similar projects, relies heavily on community participation.
This is truly a river-wide effort to clean up, catalog, and control all the plastic waste that is choking our waterways, choking our ecology, and having a terrible effect on our infrastructure and everything that we use this great resource for.
Sounds like a hefty responsibility to put in the hands of the average citizen, and a much bigger problem than a community cleanup event can solve. So how exactly are they planning to tackle this?
You know, cleanups have been happening for over 35 years in many cases, and, you know, people were just thinking, this is how we need to manage this material.
Dr. Jenna Jambeck is a professor of environmental engineering at the University of Georgia. Around 2010, she had the idea for her students to collect exact GPS coordinates of litter they found in their local environment.
If we collect data on what we're finding, then you can sort of think more and more upstream, like, why is this plastic bag here? You know, is there not infrastructure? Are there not trash cans for people to use? Or is there some sort of activity around here that produces this kind of litter more?
When smartphones became more widely available, Jenna and her team created the Marine Debris Tracker app that allows anyone to upload the data of what the litter item is and where it was found.
The litter on the ground is representative of the activities that we're doing. And one really striking example of that is the PPE that we have started wearing because of the pandemic, and especially right away, a lot of the disposable masks, wipes, and gloves that were being used. Our participatory sensing network with Debris Tracker showed us that was entering the environment within a week.
Just by a show of hands, who has at least downloaded the Marine Debris Tracker app? All right, okay, that's really great.
This cleanup event in Madison County was one of the many events that utilized the Marine Debris Tracker app as part of the Plastic Pollution Initiative. The app will create a plastic pollution map, which is publicly available for anyone to see and will ideally be used to create solutions.
It was kind of the breakthrough when we realized that we could do this by enlisting ordinary people as scientists.
Barbara Hendrie is the director of the North American Office of the United Nations Environment Program, who is a leading partner of the Mississippi River Plastic Pollution Initiative.
This will be, as far as I'm aware, the first time that there has been a data map of plastic pollution along the river. We have the capability to do a brand audit to understand, are there particular kinds of plastic that are showing up more than others? And with that data, we hope then through the mayor's offices and through our citizens groups to actually do something about it. That's the point of the initiative, is to try to reduce the amount of plastic that's flowing into the Mississippi River and through the Mississippi into the Gulf and then into our oceans.
So what do you say to the people that might be thinking, you know, so what? We've got plenty of space in the ocean. You know, what is that importance of not only cleaning up that plastic, but preventing further plastic pollution?
It's huge. So, for example, you may not know, but our oceans around the world create 60 to 80% of our atmospheric oxygen. If we choke our oceans with plastic pollution, we're choking ourselves. Plus the fact that plastic never disappears. Virtually all of the plastic that's ever been produced since the 1950s is still with us, and a majority of that is in our environment. What happens is it breaks up into smaller and smaller pieces, into microplastics that release toxins into the environment, into the drinking water, into us. So there's a very direct relationship between human health and plastic pollution.
Although keeping plastic out of our waters is the obvious objective to this initiative, Jenna and the Plastic Pollution Initiative team intentionally placed a particular piece of plastic directly into the Mississippi. Equipped with a GPS tracker, this bottle tag will provide more data to support what is already being collected from the Debris Tracker app.
So in 2015, I worked to develop a model of how much plastic was entering our oceans globally. And that number at the time was 8 million metric tons. But this was an estimate and a model that we built based upon some available data. And so this tracker is going to provide real data of how far a plastic item that makes its way into the river could actually travel.
You know, we have a massive biodiversity crisis. The problem is of a huge magnitude, but actually, every individual citizen scientist who goes out can add up to a cumulative impact on the problem. So it is possible for people to change things.
For Living St. Louis, I'm Brooke Butler.